audio story from Rishi.
How Ratnakara became sage Valmiki. Ratnakara was son of a sage and he lived with his parents inside the forest. One day while playing, young Ratnakara got lost in the dense forest. Just then a hunter saw this weeping little boy. He pacified Ratnakara and took him home. The hunter and his wife had no children, so they raised Ratnakara as their own son. Soon, Ratnakara forgot about his birth parents and grew up to become a hunter. Few years later, he got married and had many children, but he was unable to meet the needs of this large family. So, he began looting the passerbys. Ratnakara would stand at the forest borders connecting two villages and rob anyone who passed by. If they resisted, Ratnakara would kill them mercilessly. One day, Sage Narada passed by Ratnakara's robbing spot. Ratnakara stopped the sage.
"Come on, give me everything you have, or else..."
Narada said, "Narayana, Narayana, I have only one veena. What use is it for you? By the way, why are you robbing innocent people? Don't you know it is sin to loot others?" Ratnakara was instantly drawn to the bright glow on Narada Muni's face. He became calm and replied,
"I have a large family to take care of and I have no skills. So robbing is the only way for me."
Narada said, "So you are feeding your wife and children with robbed money. Have you ever asked them if they will share your sins? If not, only you will face punishments for this sin." Ratnakara began thinking. He said,
"Of course, my old parents, my wife and my children are using this robbed money to live. So, they will also have to share the sin of robbing."
Narada said, "Okay, why don't you go find out? Go home and ask your parents, wife and children. Don't worry, I shall wait right here." Confused, Ratnakara tied up Narada to a tree nearby and quickly ran home. He asked each of his family members,
"Did you all know stealing is a sin? I will get punishments for this. I am committing this crime for all of you. So, will you share my sin of robbing?"
Everyone said,
"No, it is your job to look after us. We don't care how you earn. We cannot partake in your sins, you sinner."
Realization dawned upon Ratnakara. He ran back to Narada.
"Oh, Muni, save me. I did everything for them, but none of my family members want share of my sins."
Narada said, "Narayana, Narayana, there is only one way to get rid of your sins. Close your eyes and chant Rama, 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 Rama. You will get whatever you want, Ratnakara." But Ratnakara could not get himself to chant Rama, Rama. Then Narada Muni suggested, "Chant Mara 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 Mara." Having thus instructed, Narada Muni left. Ratnakara closed his eyes and went on tapasya. He chanted,
"Mara Mara 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 Mara."
Years later, Narada Muni arrived at the same place and found a huge anthill. From within the anthill, he heard Rama 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 Rama. He peeped inside and found that Ratnakara had gone into such deep penance that his body got covered with anthill. Narada Muni saw that he had also become a wise and learned person. He woke Ratnakara. Narada Muni said, "Ratnakara, you have pleased the gods with your tapasya. And hereafter, you will be known as Valmiki, one who was born out of an anthill." Thus, dacoit Ratnakara changed himself with courage and self-discipline and became Sage Valmiki. Renowned Sage Valmiki is known as Adikavi, and he went on to author one of the greatest kavyas of Hinduism, Srimad Valmiki Ramayanam. The end.